beautiful day.
Kyle! You have to wake up! Kyle!
What?
You have to wake up and do the Good Morning Movie Review!
What?
You have to wake up and do the morning review! The movie's called Good Morning! We have to do it now!
I don't want to do the Good Morning Movie Review.
Kyle, it's morning!
Good morning to this.
Kyle, it's morning. It's very light outside. You have to do it. The movie is called Good Morning.
Now we have
yes,
to do it?
Yes, it's now while it's morning. Oh. No good afternoon, no good night. It's called Good Morning.
I don't want to do it now. I'm too tired. I don't want to do more reviews today.
Kyle, it doesn't matter. You have to do it now while it's morning.
I don't want to do more reviews today. I'm too tired.
Kyle, the camera's already rolling.
What?
It's rolling!
Oh, the camera's rolling?
Oh, yeah!
Good morning!
Good morning! Good morning to you!
Another movie review.
Good morning! Good morning! It's great to stay up late. Good morning! Good morning to you! And you and you! Good morning! Good morning to you!
When the band began to play, the stars were shining bright.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, today may suck. Good morning, good morning, good morning, you never wake up. Good morning, good morning, good morning, today may suck. Now, Lisa.
Yeah?
Why did you wake me up again?
Because we're reviewing Good Morning.
Oh, so today might not suck.
Yeah.
So we're doing another more review, right?
Yes, we are.
Hey, what's up? Kyle here again. I'm here with my wonderful, beautiful girlfriend, Lisa, here again. X is with the star, XX.
Hey, guys!
I was very tired this morning.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh. At least I got some good sleep.
Yeah. But, yeah, we're here. I'm still tired from smoking all that weed and all that. So stoned and... No, just kidding. Just kidding. But I don't do that. I don't do drugs or anything. But, we just got done seeing, Good Morning. I didn't think I was going to wake up in the morning to see Good Morning. with a U.
Not M-O-R-N-I-N-G.
No,
M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G. Yeah, he spelled it right.
Because I'm looking at the freaking thing on screen. The screen. But, I'm still waking up. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. I like that music.
Good morning.
But, this is, the Good Morning Review. It stars Machine Gun Kelly, Dove Cameron. Who else is in it? Dove Cameron from
Snoop Dogg makes a cameo.
He makes a small cameo, but
Avril Lavigne makes a small cameo too.
Avril Lavigne makes a small cameo.
To be honest, I thought Avril Lavigne was gonna get a bigger role in this.
Yeah.
Because I saw her like in the main title. I was like, oh, is she a big part? Nope, cameo.
Mm-hmm.
Which was honestly disappointing because I like her. She's actually one of my favorite singers growing up.
Yeah.
So...
I like her too.
Yeah. But I don't think she's an actress though. I think she's like more of a singer.
Who else was in this one? Becky G.
Becky G. I have no idea who Becky G is. Just a lot of people.
Fill me in because I'm
Coulson,
still very tired.
Coulson Baker.
Baker.
He played the main role of London Crash.
London, yeah. London Crash, yeah.
And then the rest of the cast, I never even heard of the rest of the cast. Oh, Megan Fox.
Megan Fox was in it too, yeah.
Yeah, she played...
She has red hair in it.
Pink hair.
Pink hair.
She was also in Jennifer's Body, and I think she's mostly known for the Transformers films.
Well, she's in a lot of stuff, yeah.
Yeah, but I think people mostly know her from like Transformers.
But we just got done seeing... It's a comedy film. It's a
stoner film.
Stoner comedy film.
Not
really well known. We were going to see it in the theater, but it wasn't...
It was not made in the theaters, though.
It wasn't in many theaters. Theaters near us, but we had to stream it on... It's on Amazon Prime for $6.99.
Yeah, we had to pay for it.
But what'd you think of it?
I have to say is, like, the comedy was good. I like the storyline. Mm-hmm. All I have to say is, I felt like the pacing kind of went a little back and forth for some reason. Like, one scene, it was like, oh my god, it's gonna get going, and then all of a sudden, it's like, nope, now I have to deal with this plot. Babe, wake up.
Okay. Whoa.
It was like, we have to do this character arc, and then do this character arc. It was like, I felt like the film kind of went all over the place, but in the end, though, I thought it was alright. Not one of the best, like, dude!
I'm just keep falling asleep. I'm sorry.
Not one of the best films that I don't think I've seen, but this, like, I mean, I don't watch a lot of Storm films.
Sing the song again so I can wake up.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. I sorry. Now I'm gonna...
At least talk.
I'm talking. I'm trying. I'm trying to stay up and wake up. Wake up. Wake me up when September ends. Anyways, continue with the plot.
Anyway, so regarding the plot. Yeah, yes, plus. So this film is about this guy named London Clash. He is a movie star, but then he gets a text. All of a sudden, he gets a text from his girlfriend.
Yeah.
Which named Apple, by the way. Like, who named their kid Apple?
I don't know who names their kid Apple. Like, what? What did he want? A piece of apple? He wanted
apple pie.
Apple pie.
And then Apple is also a name.
Apple pie, like American pie.
And then Apple. And then Apple may be related to a Mac company. It's related to the Apple Store. Apple computers. Apple iPhones.
Yeah. Well, Apple. I like the name.
She's after a name of an iPhone.
It's the weirdest name I ever heard of. Apple. Like,
Who named their kid Apple? It's original.
It is original. I mean, like, but it's just a weird name. I don't know.
Anyways, back to the plot. So basically, he gets his text, and then he thinks that his girlfriend Apple broke up with him.
Mm-hmm.
But then all of a sudden,
it was a weird movie.
All I have to say is like, he goes on this like kind of like wild goose chase just to find her, and then all of a sudden he gets into this talent agency who wants him to be the new Batman, which I don't know why they have to throw Batman in this movie.
Why don't they just throw Robert Pattinson in the movie too?
Robert Pattinson would be a nice cameo.
Or Val Kilmer, what's his name? You know the guy.
Ben Affleck.
No, yeah, Ben Affleck.
He was a Batman.
Why don't they just throw the one that everyone likes, the Batman. I can't believe I'm not knowing this right now. I'm still half asleep, sorry. What's the guy? That played Batman, the really big, famous one.
Shoot.
Oh my God. What's going on with us, Lisa?
No idea.
What's the one that everyone likes? The Batman one.
Well.
Oh, fuck.
Anyway, we'll think of it later. But anyways, it'll come to us later. But,
did Tom Cruise play Batman? No.
No. But anyways, enough Batman talking now. Anyways, so basically he goes on this wild goose chase, doing all...
Christian Bale!
There you go. I told you it'll come up later, buddy boy.
Christian Bale.
But anyways, though, he basically goes on this wild goose chase to look for his girlfriend and try to, like, at least, work things out. And then, pretty much, a lot of shenanigans happen, like, the vase breaks with all the family's ashes. And then this guy, like, I forgot his name, but, all to say is, like, the guys are, like, kind of, I feel like most of the cast are kind of, like, forgettable.
This is, like, one of those movies where it's, like,
But then, let me tell him. Oh. And then, this one guy tries to, like, fix it. But then that's why this one guy is addicted to weed. This other guy, like, wants a hot date with someone. And then all the city, and then this talent agency tries to, like, get this guy to become the new Batman, as I said before. But this guy keeps getting, like rigged after rigged after rigged. Like, he feels like his life is kind of going down the toilet because,
Well, you don't want to give too much
away. Yeah, I don't want to give too much away. But all I have to say to this guy is if you are really, I guess, bored throughout the day. If you want to put on something that make you laugh, I guess.
Turn off your brain.
Yeah, this is like one of those movies that you really just gotta turn off your brain for.
Kind of remind me of like How High or like that movie with
Halle Kumar.
The Snoop Dogg movie with Annie Milonakis.
What was
that movie called?
I forgot what it is, but I know a couple of YouTubers reviewed it.
That movie with Mac. What was it, the rapper Mac D or what was it, Mac something?
I forgot.
Mac Z or Mac, what's the guy? I can't think of the guy. Mac something was in it. And Snoop Dogg, Mac D and...
I forget.
I can't think of anything anymore. I'm losing it.
That's because you're tired.
Yeah.
But anyway, so again, it's like that movie like he mentioned before.
I don't know what the I forget the damn I forgot, the I forgot what it is called. Too.
But guys,
you should know this. You told me about the movie.
Yeah, guys. Leave in the comments if you guys know what the movie he and I are talking about.
The movie with Snoop Dogg and
Annie Malakas,
and I don't think he's the star of that.
Though, he just makes a cameo.
No,
I think.
It's Snoop Dogg, and it's like some high school movie where
it's about
rappers that go to high school and they get stoned or something.
Yes, that's
some
correct.
Stoner movie when they go to high school and they go to like school and they get the kids stoned or something.
It was like
a direct DVD movie from 2008 or something. Or 2018, I can't even remember.
I think it's 2008.
Some movie I forget the title. I'm not good with titles anymore.
Ugh, you think?
But I think this is like a hit or miss, this movie.
Yeah.
Or like, it's like, there's like movie. This is one of those movies where it's like, there's good, funny jokes.
Yep.
There's bad jokes. Mm-hmm. There's jokes that'll make you laugh. There's like, it's like one of those movies where it's like, oh, there's just like some really, really funny jokes. There's some jokes that are lame. And there's jokes that are just not really funny. Like, you know, it's not.
It's like a little bit of everything, I guess.
Yeah,
I don't know.
It's just not like. It's the weirdest. It's a weird movie. It's not one of the best movies I've seen.
Yeah,
and it seemed like a TikTok movie.
Yeah, all this is like 2022 the movie.
2022 the movie, like a TikTok movie.
Instagram gets mentioned.
Yeah, there's a lot of Instagram TikTok references.
Yeah, I don't have a TikTok, so he and I don't have TikTok. So
I have a TikTok, but I don't use it.
We don't get the references. We're sorry.
I have a TikTok, but I don't use it. Don't.
I don't get the references. Yeah. I don't have a TikTok though.
I get some of the reference. I don't know anymore. This new social media stuff.
Yeah, same here. I mean, I have an Instagram, but.
Yeah, I have an Instagram. And
I'm
well,
active
you can follow
Instagram,
me on
though.
Instagram and follow. Well, I'll get all to that at
the end.
Yeah, you know all our plug and shit.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But anyways, for the movie, what would you give the rating?
I give it a 7.8 out of 10.
Okay.
Not too. It's good, but it's not perfect.
Understandable.
What would you give it?
All to say is though, the comedy. Some of the comedy. Even I feel like Megan Fox honestly saved the movie.
And Dove Cameron was.
Dove Cameron.
Yeah,
oh,
I liked her in this.
She saved this movie.
Yeah, she
Dove
did.
Cameron freaking killed
and
it.
Machine Gun Kelly was in it too.
He's
the star of it.
Yeah.
He was really good. There was a lot of good people in it.
I mean, they're a good cast, but
good
the
cast.
Story was just like, eh.
It was somewhat all over the place.
Dove Cameron, though, saved the
some
movie.
Some of it was just
Dove
some...
Cameron freaking saved the movie.
Yeah.
But I think for my rating, I have to give it an 8 out of 10 because I love Dove Cameron. I love Megan Fox in it. Megan Fox, to be fair, I feel like she was like, the funniest.
Mm-hmm.
And Dove Cameron was your, like, like an agent who pretty much is like no monkey business.
Mm-hmm.
Like, but she had some funny scenes though. But she was like really, really good in this movie. I just watched it just for Dove. If you guys like Dove Cameron, just watch it just for Dove Cameron.
Yeah.
And Megan Fox. If you think Megan Fox, you think her career's over. I feel like she made a kind of good revival.
And Avril Lavigne came back for like a little cameo.
I'm shocked, thinking like, oh my god, is she gonna make a major role? But yeah, honestly, I was disappointed that Avril Lavigne didn't get much screen time, though. She was just only there for like a one-time cameo, because I love her growing up, so... But anyways, we're not here to praise Avril Lavigne, even though she's awesome. We're here to talk about the movie. But anyways, I think the movie was, like, again, it was, like, not the best movie we've seen this year.
Mm-hmm.
Even though we'll have, like, more, like, treasures down the road. This one was just, like, an eh... So 8 out of 10, as I said, though, for me, though, because I liked the female characters in this.
Mm-hmm.
But, again, I feel like this is, like, pretty much just 2022 of the movie in a nutshell.
Yeah.
Again, I grew up in the 90s. We both grew up with, like, in the 90s, so we don't get what the trends are nowadays. Yeah. I mean, I'm still active on YouTube and Instagram, and I don't know what their freaking trends are on social media and whatnot.
Mm.
The only newest social media I guess I have just Instagram. Well, Instagram has been around since like 2013.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think it's been around since 2013. But anyways, with its updates and whatnot. But anywho.
Yeah.
Take it away.
Anyways, definitely check. Should we recommend it?
I would recommend it if you're a Dove Cameron fan. And if you want to see Megan Fox's career coming back.
Yeah.
That's all I have to say.
And if you like the other cast members and
Machine
Gun Kelly and like the...
Tom Arnold, though.
Tom Arnold was in it, too. I like Tom Arnold. And like everybody, there's a lot of good cast members.
I mean, the cast members did a good job.
There's a lot of good cameos and things and pop-ins in there, here and there.
Yeah.
But there's some really good stuff in there, like really good moments in there. I liked it. It's not perfect. The comedy was good. Some of it was a little off the wall funny. Like off color funny.
Yeah.
But it was really good. I definitely would check it out. 7.8 out of 10. Not a total 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
But I do recommend it. It's definitely one to check out. But that ending, I can say. We're not going to spoil it, but that ending was not. That's what made it not a full 10 out of 10.
Yeah, the ending was terrible. The
ending was terrible. So that's why I don't give it a full 10 out of 10. But definitely check out Good Morning with the M-U-O. M-O... I almost spelled it wrong.
Oh, God.
Good morning. M-O-U-R-I-N-G. Yeah, I almost spelled it wrong.
Don't worry about it.
I'm not thinking straight. But definitely check out Good Morning. And rent it for $6.99 on...
Amazon.
On Prime, if you want to check it out. But definitely check it out. Really fun movie. Definitely see Good Morning. Mm. And have a good morning. Or good evening, we're watching it, whenever you watch it.
Or good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Good evening.
That was the sequel. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon is a sequel.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, but yeah, definitely check it out. Anyway, though, guys, hope we just moved you there. We did. Thanks a lot for watching and subscribing. And before I end this video, I want to give a quick couple shout outs. And like, I want to show this really cool shirt that I got. From my buddy John Henderson from Doomsday's Crypt. He got this shirt. It's a Doomsday's Crypt shirt, and it has the lettering was done by his friends Thomas Bruce, and the art was done by Michael Toth. Really cool guys that are good friends of ours, and That I got really awesome news. They're actually designing shirts for me, for my channel. For my YouTube channel. Yeah, finally getting shirts done. They're designing shirts for my YouTube channel. I'm gonna be selling them. I'll let you all know when that comes. When those come out and when. I don't want to show. I have the art on my phone, but I don't want to show it yet because I don't want to reveal the really cool. It's a really cool design that they're doing. And so Thomas Bruce is doing the lettering. My friend Thomas Bruce is doing the lettering, and my friend Michael Toth is doing the art. And John Henderson is helping me out. Doomsday's Crypt. Definitely check him out on Doomsday's Crypt on YouTube. I'll put a link underneath this video for his YouTube channel.
Give him support,
and I'll put a link for his Facebook page and Michael Toth's for John Henderson's Facebook page and Michael Toth's Facebook page. He does amazing artwork, and Thomas Bruce's Facebook page. And then they did some artwork in the back. Really cool guys. Definitely check them out. I was on his podcast, on Doomsday's Crypt podcast recently. He's a really cool guy. He's been supporting me He's been very supportive of my work and everything. I love you, Doomsday's Crypt and Michael Toth and Thomas Bruce. Thank you guys so much. You guys are awesome. You guys are great. Thank you guys so much for all your support. Also, want to mention I got other great news. A lot of great news. Me and Doug's movie from we made back in 2009.
Whoa.
A little movie called, it was originally called The Legend of the Shackle Demon. Now it's called The Shackle Demon Project. It was on Vimeo, but now it's getting a Blu-ray release, and the trailers are now up on my YouTube channel.
Check it out.
The new trailers that are getting a Blu-ray release and they're going to streaming. If you haven't seen those trailers yet, there's two different trailers, the Doug trailer and the Kyle trailer.
Yep.
And it's a really fun found footage movie, 85 minutes. Really fun, and it's going to have a really cool release. It's an actual release that I'm getting. A really fun release put out by my buddy Septim Sin versus the World from YouTube. I'm giving him a shout out. He's a good friend of mine. He's putting it out. And my buddy Evan Jacobs from Anadenia Films is putting it out, and the person selling the movies, I can't say who, but there's a big distributor that's going to be selling these movies. A Ooh. really good, I'm gonna keep that surprise at a surprise, but I'm getting really good cover art for it, really cool design for it. It's really cool. I would show you there's a lot of cool things going on. I'm getting like stickers and stamps and like things. This is gonna be a really cool release. You guys, wait till you guys see this. I'm gonna promote the hell out of this thing.
Mm-hmm.
This is a really cool, exciting thing that I'm getting done, and these shirts are getting done for me. So there's a lot of cool things coming up for me. There's movies that I'm gonna be coming up in, and then also I want to mention I'm gonna be tune in June 5th on
next Sunday,
June 5th. Well, this might be delayed if they're watching this, but if
yeah.
June 5th, I'm going to be on my buddy, I'm going to be on another podcast, my buddy, check out his YouTube channel. His YouTube channel is Have Cheetah Will View. His name is Patrick Michael. I'm going to be on his podcast on June 5th, 5:00 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, talking about my career and stuff in movies. I'm gonna be on this podcast, and I'm gonna be interviewed. So definitely tune in on Sunday, June 5th, and I'm gonna be on his show. So definitely check him out and give him all your support. He's a really cool guy too. And definitely check out the Horror Freak 85. I want to give him another shout out too. Put a link underneath this video for his channel. He's another really cool YouTuber that's been supporting me and helping me as well. But anyway though, guys, hope you enjoyed this movie review that we did. Thanks a lot for watching and subscribing. And also, Sharkula's coming out soon too.
Woo!
Sharkula, that's coming out in a couple of days soon to DVD from Wild Eye Releasing. But anyway though, guys, yeah, that's going to be a really cool movie. Sharkula is going to be a really fun movie. I'm really excited for people to see that. But anyway though, guys, hope you enjoyed this movie review that we did. Thanks a lot for watching and subscribing. Definitely give the video a thumbs up. Leave a comment below. Please rate, subscribe. Hit up my girlfriend on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Tumblr. Follow her on MeWe. Subscribe to her XX with the Star XX on YouTube. Thanks a lot for watching and subscribing. I'll see y'all later.
All right.
Peace. I forgot what movie we were reviewing.
Good morning.
Oh, yeah. Good morning. Good morning. Go see Good Morning. And have a good morning. You know, good evening. Good night.
Or afternoon, whenever you're watching this.
Yeah. Peace.
See you later.
See you later. Hope you enjoy it. Peace.